This is part 43 of Angular 2 tutorial. In this video, we will wrap up Angular 2 course and also get an idea of what we plan to do next. In this course so far, we have discussed what is a component, creating a component and a nested component, passing data between parent and child components using the component input and output properties, different ways of applying styles to components, interpolation, property, class, style, and event bindings, how Angular 2-way data binding keeps component class properties and HTML element values in sync using the Angular structural directives ngIf and ngFor, transform data before display using the built-in Angular pipes, and we also discussed creating our own custom pipes, creating custom types for the business objects that we create like employee, customer, order, etc. using the TypeScript interfaces, component lifecycle hooks, creating a service that retrieves data from a remote web service, using Bootstrap to style Angular components, how routing works in Angular and passing parameters to routes, what is dependency injection and how it is implemented in Angular, finally, how to work with observables and promises in Angular. As you have seen throughout the course, Angular provides a consistent set of patterns for creating components, pipes, and services. As we already discussed in our previous video, from a developer standpoint, there's no much difference between Angular 2 and Angular 4. The way we create an Angular application is very identical whether we use Angular 2 or Angular 4 version. Angular 4 is simply the next version of Angular 2. All the Angular concepts that we have learned so far as part of this course are still valid, and we can still use those same concepts to build an Angular application using version 4. So here is what we plan to do next, a short course on a tool called Angular CLI. Angular CLI is a command line tool that helps us create, build, and test Angular applications faster and with great consistency while still following the Angular team's best practices and conventions. This tool generates the boilerplate code in no time for components, directives, pipes, services, etc. I personally think Angular CLI is an extremely useful tool, and every Angular developer should know how to use it, as it greatly improves our productivity when developing Angular applications. As part of this short course, we will learn everything we need to know to effectively and efficiently use this tool to improve our productivity while still following the Angular team's best practices and conventions. So once we are comfortable with this Angular CLI tool, we will use it to create a brand new Angular 4 project from scratch. As part of this project, we will learn all the CRUD operations, that is, create, read, update, and delete operations. To learn all these CRUD operations, we'll create a form that looks like this. Along the way, we'll also discuss form validation and working with different HTML elements like text boxes, radio buttons, checkboxes, select list, etc. We'll also discuss using third-party form controls like date picker, rating control, etc. So, if you have a comment, question, or would like us to include any other Angular concept in our upcoming courses, please leave them as comments on this video and we will surely include them. Thank you for listening, have a great day, and please stay tuned for our new courses on Angular.